गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, वेलकम टू ओजस्वात आई एस अकेडमी. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द एम सी क्यूज ऑफ 18 जून, एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन अस ऑन आर टेलीग्राम चैनल वेयर वी अपलोड ऑल दीज पीपीटीज एंड देन यू कैन डू मल्टीपल रिविजन ऑफ दैम. नाउ लेट्स चेक आउट वट आर द 10 टॉपिक्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर टूडे. सो हेयर इज द लिस्ट इज गिवन एंड ट्राई टू गेट एटलीस्ट 7 क्वेश्चन करेक्ट आउट ऑफ 10. सो वर्क हार्ड, बी कंसिस्टेंट, रेगुलरली वॉच आर वीडियोज. And let's start our today's MCQs. So question number 1 is with reference to border adjustment tax. Statement first, the tax is proposed to be imposed on imported goods in place of the custom duty at the port of entry. Second, the tax will aid the domestic industry to be more competitive compared to the imported products. So the correct option here is B. That means statement first is incorrect. Because border adjustment tax is a duty that is proposed to be imposed on imported goods in addition to the custom duty, not in place of, at the port of entry. And this is proposed to help domestic industry to be more competitive. And the domestically produced Indian goods are charged with a number of taxes like electricity duty, fuel duty, clean energy cess, etc. But most of the imported goods are not charged with such taxes in their country of origin, and this gives such products price advantage in the Indian market. And context is that a Niti Aayog member has favored imposing BAT, that means border adjustment tax, on imports to provide a level playing field to domestic industries so that it would help domestic industry to be more competitive. Now question number 2 is with reference to Agarbatti sector. Statement first, Agarbatti making industry is labor based, requiring a very small capital and less technical skill. Second, Indian Agarbatti sector is capable to meet its domestic demands and exports in incense sticks. So here the correct option is A. That means statement second is incorrect. Because there is a huge gap between the demand and supply, which resulting in heavy import of raw agarbatti from China and Vietnam. Also, Ministry of Commerce on August 29 had placed the import of agarbatti under restricted category, thus reviving the domestic industry. But it prompted the local traders to import round bamboo sticks for manufacturing of raw agarbatti, which resulted in huge import of bamboo stick from the countries. So even if we are capable to produce these kind of products domestically, but if we are depend on other countries on the raw materials or anything else, then it would definitely harm the purpose of Atmanirbhar Bharat scheme. And because India is very much dependent on bamboo stick, so recently central government has decided to increase import duty on bamboo sticks from 10% to 25%, which aimed at reducing the imports and help local industry grow. And India is the second largest producer of bamboo in the world, but also the second largest importer of bamboo in its products. So check out why the scenario is like this, where India, even being a largest producer or second largest producer, is also a second largest importer of bamboo or anything else. Now question number 3 is with reference to Bose-Einstein condensate. Statement first, it is the fifth state of matter after solid, liquid, gas and plasma. Second, it is formed when atoms of certain elements are cooled to 0 degree Celsius. So the correct option here is A. That means it is fifth state of matter, but statement second is incorrect, because it is formed when atoms of certain elements are cooled to near absolute zero or 0 Kelvin, not 0 degree Celsius. And it was predicted by Albert Einstein and Indian physicist and mathematician Satyendra Nath Bose in mid 1920s. And when Bosonic atoms are cooled at very low temperature to form a condensate. They lose their individuality and behave like one big collective super atom. And context is that scientists of International Space Station have recently observed the fifth state of matter in space for the first time. So do remember it. There are five state of matter currently, which are known to scientists. Now, question number 4 is, the Nature Index 2020 recently released rates country on the basis of. So the correct option here is C, meaning high quality scientific research. So the Nature Index is a database of author affiliation information collated from research articles published in an internationally independently selected group of 82 high quality science journals. So it is a database of high quality research output, and it has been released recently, which India is being placed at 12th position globally in science research output. And top 3 institutions of India are CSIR, IISc and TIFR. And the top 5 countries are USA, China, Germany, UK and Japan. Now question number 5 is, which of the following prizes is also known as Asia's Nobel Prize? So the correct option here is B, that means Raman Magsaysay Award. So this award is also known as Asia's Nobel Prize, and the prize is named after Raman Magsaysay, third president of Philippines, and was established by New York based Rockefeller Brothers Fund in 1957. And many Indians have also received this award, including Vinoba Bhave, Mother Teresa, Jay Prakash Narayan, Kiran Bedi and Sonam Bonchuk. And context is that these awards for 2020 have been cancelled due to coronavirus pandemic, and it is only the third time the annual awards have been disrupted in decades, 60 years. Now question number 6 is, consider the following statements regarding fuel prices in India. Statement first, retail prices of petrol and diesel in India are linked to the global crude prices. Second, it means if crude prices fall, retail prices should come down too, and vice versa. Third, this is also happening with fuel prices in India. Fourth, oil price decontrol is a one-way street in India. So the correct option here is A, that means statement third is incorrect, because the trend that if crude prices fall, retail prices should come down too, and vice versa, is not happening in India. And one main reason is oil price decontrol is a one-way street in India. When global prices go up, this is passed on to the consumer, but when the reverse happens and the prices go down, the government almost by default slaps fresh taxes and levies to ensure that it takes in extra revenues. So the key beneficiary in this subversion of price decontrol is government, and the consumer is looking like a clear loser alongside fuel retailing companies are as well. So these are the mismatch in Indian scenario, so you have to remember this. Now question number 7 is, recently iFlows Mumbai was in news. Statement first, it is an integrated flood warning system. Second, it will be able to relay alerts of possible flood prone areas anywhere between 6 to 72 hours in advance. Third, Mumbai is the first city in the country to get this system. So here the correct option is C, because statement third is incorrect, as Mumbai is the only second city after Chennai to get this system. And the primary source for the system is the amount of rainfall, but with Mumbai being a coastal city, the system also factors in tidal waves and storm trials for its flood assessment. And the system has provisions to capture the urban drainage within the city and predict the areas of flooding. Also, the system comprises 7 modules. Now, question number 8 is, consider the following statements regarding deaths due to COVID-19 in India. Statement first, more than 3/4 of the deaths have been happening in UP, Gujarat and Rajasthan. Second, this number has been increasing. So the correct option here is B, because statement first is incorrect, as more than 3/4 of deaths have been happening in Maharashtra, Gujarat and Delhi. And as India keeps on adding more and more novel coronavirus cases each day, the most worrisome metrics now is the consequent rise in the number of deaths. And although deaths as a proportion of total number of cases have actually gone down in the last 1 month, but in absolute terms, it is becoming a big number. So it is a worry, because the rate of death compared to recovery rate might be low, but in absolute terms, it is a huge or a big number. More you can check out in the graph. Now question number 9 is, what is the GST rate attracted by ready-to-eat parathas? This was recently news. So I hope you can answer it correctly. And the correct option is C, that means 18%, because ready-to-eat parathas, unlike khakra, plain chapatis or roti, need to be heated or further processed for human consumption and hence are liable for 18% GST. This is a ruling which is given by Karnataka bench of the Authority of Advanced Ruling. Also, do check out this additional information, but you have to remember that the rate of GST for chapati and parathas are different, and reason you will find in the additional information. Now question number 10 is, recently Sitamarhi was in news, so where is it located? So this is a place, you have to choose the correct option. So the correct option is B, that means it is located in India and in Bihar. And recently it was in news because an Indian national was killed and two other were injured recently when the Nepal armed police force responsible for border security opened fire on a group during a clash at a border point near this Sitamarhi in Bihar. So that's all in our today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the lecture. And question for today is, who started Bhudan movement in India? And who was the leader of Bardoli Satyagraha? So if you want to contact us, these are the details. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of the videos. Also like, comment and share the video. And if you want to contact us regarding UPSC examination and its test series, you can also contact us. So stay safe, stay healthy, have a nice day and thank you. Good morning.